Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Deputy Commander of United States Forces Korea, Lieutenant General Scott L. Plois, welcome to today's change of command ceremony, in which Major General Ryan M. Wolford will relinquish command to Major General William E. Souza III. Today's ceremony is being conducted by the Marines of Marine Corps Forces Korea. The commander of troops for today's ceremony is Colonel Kip A. Walgren. Please rise for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the invocation given by Lieutenant Colonel Joshua N. Payne, United States Air Force. The invocation will now be given by Lieutenant Colonel Joshua N. Payne, United States Air Force.
Tradition of honor and legacy of valor of the 42 Medal of Honor recipients and nearly 4,300 Marines who gave their last full measure of devotion to free our friends from a tyrant's quest. As General Souza assumes the guidance of command, I pray that you would give him the strength of Samson, the wisdom of Solomon, and the patience of Job to continue reassuring the land of the morning calm that they have no better friend than his Marines. In your most holy name I pray. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Present-day parades in the Marine Corps have their basis in both history and tradition. The mass formation of troops on one long line at close interval made possible the massing of firepower from muzzle-loaded muskets of yesterday. In those early days, the line of battle was just that, a line of two or three ranks, and looked much like the parade formation you will see today. The adjutant forms the line for battle. The adjutant is Major Peter F. Izaevich. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the March on of the Colors and remain standing for the national anthem of the Republic of Korea and the United States. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The parade adjutant now presents the assembled command to the commander of troops. Ladies and gentlemen, the Deputy Commander of United States Forces Korea, Lieutenant General Scott L. Poyce, has deferred honors to the Commander of Marine Corps Forces Korea and the incoming Commander. Please rise for honors to Major General Wolford. Honors to Major General Wolford. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Now joining Major General Wolford in the reviewing area to assume command of Marine Corps Forces Korea is Major General William E. Souza III.
Sergeant Major, deliver the colors to the commander.
Ladies and gentlemen, We now come to the ceremony's most solemn moment, the actual passing of command. The battle colors of a Marine Corps unit symbolize the authority and accountability of command. Transferring the colors during the ceremony symbolizes the relinquishing of command by Major General Wolford, and by accepting the colors, Major General Souza III accepts command and confirms his total commitment to the Marines and sailors that he will command. Sergeant Major Souza Rodriguez is delivering the colors to the commanding general. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the passing of the colors. From Commandant of the Marine Corps to Major General Brian N. Wolford, subject relinquishment of command. Effective 09/9/2023, you stand attached as the commander, U.S. Marine Corps Forces Korea. Signed, David H. Berger, General, United States Marine Corps, Commandant of the Marine Corps. From Commandant of the Marine Corps to Major General William E. Souza III, subject assumption of command. Effective 09/9/2023, you are directed to report for duty as the commander, United States Marine Corps Forces Korea. Signed, David H. Berger, General, United States Marine Corps, Commandant of the Marine Corps. Honors to Major General Souza, Commander, Marine Corps Forces Korea. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The following letters are provided from the Commandant of the Marine Corps to Major General Brian N. Wolford. Brian, congratulations on a job well done. The accomplishments of Marine Corps Forces Korea during your tenure are a direct reflection of your outstanding leadership. I know firsthand how much effort you put into fostering relationships with our Korean counterparts and the new Republic of Korea administration. You are undoubtedly the right Marine at the right time to lead this command. By providing a clear direction, you have set MARFORK on a path to meet challenges of the future. Meanwhile, you demonstrated foresight and initiative that made great strides in fostering our Corps to respond to any crisis or contingencies in the region. The Marine Corps is grateful to you and Okyong for your leadership as well as everything you do for our Marines, sailors, and their families. We wish you the very best in your next assignment. 2. Major General William E. Souza III. Wes, as you assume command of Marine Corps Forces Korea, know that you have my total trust and confidence. I know that you will bring the same outstanding leadership to MARFORK that you demonstrated as the Commanding General of 4th Marine Logistics Groups. Congratulations and best wishes to you and Jody as you take responsibility for the daily operations of Marine Corps Forces Korea. Semper Fidelis. Signed, David H. Berger, General, United States Marine Corps, Commandant of the Marine Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, flowers are now being delivered to Mrs. Wolford and Mrs. Souza for their unwavering support to their husbands. And a certificate of appreciation is being presented to Mrs. Wolford for her unwavering support and service to the Marines of MARFORK. Ladies and gentlemen, the Deputy Commander of United States Forces Korea, Lieutenant General Scott L. Ployce.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of General LaCamera, I would like to welcome our fellow general officers, flag officers, commanders, senior enlisted leaders, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, Anyang Hashimnika. To General An, Lieutenant General Kim, thank you for your support for the Republic of Korea Marines provide to MARFORK every day. I'd also like to recognize the Color Guard, the Combined Band, the Salute Battery with Charlie Battery, 217th Field Artillery, the UNC Honor Guard, USFK staff, ROC Marine Corps, and MARFORK teammates, and the exceptional efforts of the volunteers who put this together. If you would please join me in a round of applause for everybody and all their hard work. It is truly an honor to preside today over today's change of command ceremony on behalf of General LaCamera, honoring the change of command between two outstanding Marines. All of us in uniform know that any lasting success is only possible with the support of our loved ones. Brian, you and your wife, Okyung, have proven to be quite a team throughout your command. We'd like to express our gratitude for her numerous sacrifices to support our Marines, their families, and the local community in our alliance. Thank you very much. Wes, you and your wife, Jody, have accepted an enormous challenge, and we are proud to have you on board. Jody, thank you for supporting your husband in this new and challenging endeavor. Also, please give your appreciation to your children, Danae, Skylar, Kyle, and Connor, and welcome to the team. Our mission here is to maintain the 70-year armistice, deter North Korean aggression, and if required, defend the Republic of Korea. MARFORK punches well above its weight class and is a big part of that mission. The outgoing commander, Major General Brian Wolford, has led with distinction as the commander, U.S. Marine Forces Korea. He's also served as the deputy commander, Combined Marine Component Command, and as the service component commander, United Nations Command. Brian has shouldered the weight of command of all U.S. Marine forces assigned to USFK and UNC, while advising the USFK and UNC on the capabilities, support, and employment of Marine forces in this theater. He has ensured that if called upon, MARFORK can facilitate the rapid introduction of U.S. Marine forces onto the Korean Peninsula in order to maintain stability in Northeast Asia. Moreover, Major General Wolford was also the U.S. Marine Corps representative to the Commandant of the ROC Marine Corps here on Peninsula. Brian, congratulations on your super successful command. Only a small percentage of our countrymen ever become United States Marines. Far fewer still become general officers. You've proven yourself a model Marine, so congratulations. As we like to say to each other in the military, it's not goodbye, but see you later. Literally, you're moving up three floors, and you'll be working as the UCJ-5. We're glad to have you on board. As we say farewell to Major General Wolford, we welcome
Major General William E. Souza III. He most recently served as the commanding general of the 4th Marine Logistics Group. Wes, welcome to Korea. You are inheriting an exceptional team, and have no doubt you will lead with distinction. All our Marines deserve outstanding leadership, and I know you will provide that and more. As we honor the transition between exceptional leaders, we should also remember that MARFORK remains ready to fight tonight. As we bring the ceremony to a close, I want to leave you with two closing thoughts. First, both General LaCamera and I are proud to stand with you as we remain ready to fight tonight. Second, USFK, CFC, UNC is the most lethal, joint, combined team on the planet that enables us to fulfill our sacred task to defeat our adversaries on the land, the sea, and in the air, the areas where you will find U.S. Marines. Thank you, Marines, and thank you to all in attendance for what you do to support the ROC U.S. Alliance. We go together, kachi kachi da. Now I would like to welcome General Wolford to the podium.
First, First off, thank you for everybody for being here. I'm going to try to talk slowly. My poor interpreter, Mr. Yuke, is going to try to keep up with me because I did not give him a speech. So first off, welcome to
Mr. Ambassador, the Honorable Mr. Jung, the Mayor of Trumpet, General Lon, General Kim, Commandant of the Marine Corps, General Boyce, General Harrison, General Burleson, and Lieutenant General Jung, as well as all the sergeants, majors, command master crews, Marines, sailors, guardians, Coast Guard, Marines, and airmen.
I'm going to keep this short. But I do want to hit a couple points. First off, I want to talk about the unique nature of being here in Korea. First off, it's one of the places where we work with our joint and combined partners. And as the Army always likes to say, how do you spell joint? A-R-M-Y. But what that's done is, one, for the Marines, it gets a chance to work with all of our joint U.S. service members that work together. One, I think it makes us stronger. Things a little frustrating sometimes when we learn from each other, but being here in Korea is probably unique in the U.S. military on how they do things. So for all of the non-Marines out here, thank you for everything you've done with us over the last year. I appreciate it, and the Marines appreciate it. I'll talk about the Rock Marine Corps later. We'll get them in a few minutes. But first, I want to talk about the most important people here right now, and that's the Marines behind me. So what we've done here at MARFORK is the component is we are responsible for preparing all Marine forces to come to Korea. Over the last year, these Marines behind you have completely revitalized and expanded our exercise program to support both the joint force and the combined force, both in scheduled exercises and then regular annual training. We've updated our mission statement and all of our METs in order to reflect what we do here as the component. They've gone through and revalidated everything that we do here in support of Marine forces, both U.S. Marines and any U.N. Marine forces that come here. They went through, recognized all the shortfalls. They went through and revalidated everything that we have here, line by line, over the last year. And for you all that are familiar with some of those documents, it's quite a massive undertaking. We've realigned all of our host nation support, realigned all of our sustainment in support of the Marines. All of this, what it does, it makes Korea meth agnostic. All of their hard work means it doesn't matter what meth shows up here in Korea. They'll be ready to fight because of all the hard work that these Marines have done. I'm very proud of it, and I know our Commandant's very proud of it, that any Marine force can show up here and fight the fight. And they can focus on defeating the enemy, not worrying about all their support they're going to have in order to get to the fight. But that's for all the Marines out here. I'd like to give a round of applause for all the Marines. Now I want to talk a little about the ROC Marine Corps. They're our partners. There is no other force in the world that we are closer to than the ROC Marine Corps. What we've done over the last year, due to the hard work of the Commandant, who was previously the Assistant Commandant when I first got here, has been nothing but completely fulfilling, and I think we've moved the bar along as we continue to work towards force design for the U.S. Marine Corps and force design for the ROC Marine Corps. But for everything that the ROC Marines have done for us, sir, I want to say thank you. But all that being said, we still have a lot of work to do. Wes, as you get here, you've got a great team behind me. You've got a great team with General Kim, and you've got a great joint force here that's surrounding you right now. There's a lot of work still needs to be done. We just got the ball started. So from all my Marines, keep the momentum going for General Souza. For you and Jody, welcome. I can't think of a better person here to replace me. You are absolutely the right Marine, the right time to come in here this summer. And I'm very pleased to have you here. Last thing, a couple things. Being here at MARFORK is what I like about being a Marine. This is why I'm still a Marine. It's being with the Marines that are behind me, people that have a mission, understand duty, and we work together. I come to work every day very happy, and I enjoy being a Marine because the Marines here and everyone else that I work with over the last year. So for everybody, thank you. For all my my families on there, my mother, my father, my brother, brothers and sisters, you know, thanks for everything you've done over the last 35, 36 years, whatever it is. But thank you. Got some friends here. Thanks for being here. That doesn't happen very often. And last, I'll just close with Okyung. She's going to be mad at me. But she's put up with a lot over the years. If you didn't know, I've done 10 deployments with her. And I've been gone. She's kept the house down. And without her, I couldn't be here. And she's actually the most special person to me in the whole world. So, Yobo, Nanin Mani Salangin. Thank you, everybody.
Haseyo. Good morning and welcome. It's a really wonderful day for this event, so thank you for your attendance here. Yesterday I was in Busan and I was able to see Lieutenant General Poyce and listen to the myriad of responsibilities he has. So the fact that you're even here to facilitate this, sir, thank you so much. From Marine Forces Korea, it's my goal to ensure that we continue the value-add relationship with U.S. Forces Korea, so thank you for your attendance today, sir. To our host Nason, Lieutenant General Kim, sir, thank you so much for being here today. I know you're very busy, and I look forward over to developing our relationship over the next few years and being an excellent partner, so thank you, sir. To the Mayor of Pyeongtaek, Mr. Mayor, my wife Jody and I look forward to being contributing members to the community here, so we're really thankful and grateful to be here, and I'm thankful for your presence here as well, too. To the distinguished visitors and guests and all the wonderful faces that I'm looking at, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedules to be here today. I'm very appreciative of it and knowing that you have a lot of things to do and you took that time to come here and see this ceremony, so thank you. To the Marines of Marine Forces Korea and staff, thank you so much for cross-decking me over so that I'm able to expeditiously move out in a run pace as the commander here at Marine Forces Korea. So thank you so much for that, as well as your support out here for this ceremony. Also to the combined band and the artillery battery, I thank you so much. I wasn't expecting an artillery battery, so thank you so much for the rounds that you shot earlier. I'm an old infantry tank and AAV guy, so that ground combat arms stuff, it really gets my heart beating. I like it. My wife, Jody, I'm so grateful and thankful that you made this sacrifice to be away from family for 2 years here with me. I thank God that I have you as my wife and that we'll do this adventure together. With a very busy future ahead of us at MARFORK, I know through General Wolford's leadership and guidance that the MARFORK staff is as prepared as it possibly can be to move forward and be a good ally and partner and also serve our nation. So thank you for everything that you've done, as well as you and Okyung. You've been very generous in transitioning Jody and I here to Korea. We couldn't have done it without your help. So thank you. Just very, very deep thanks. You're so gracious in everything that you did for us. And thank you, everybody. Kamsahamnida.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of Anchors Away and the Marines Hymn, and remain standing for the remainder of the ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. On behalf of Major General Wolford, Major General Souza, officers and Marines of Marine Corps Forces Korea, we thank you for your attendance. Please join us inside the UNC Hall for the reception. At this time, please return all headsets.